Welcome back guys, and thank you for joining me again. So today I'll show you quickly how in RetroArch you can configure your controller as per your convenience. So if you're using a 4-button layout, 2-button layout, whatever you're using, a gamepad, joypad, or a Bluetooth controller, USB controller, whatever type of controller you're using, you can configure it. Just go from the shortcut menu to the controls option all the way down. You can see down, you will see a controls option. Go into that and go to port 1 controls. So here you have all your controls, which button you want to assign, A, B. Like I'm playing a Game Boy game right now, so there is only A, B and start and select. So if it's another game, if you're playing another system, you will have the options. Whichever way you want to configure it, you can configure it. So you can swap it around, try it out. Whichever it makes you feel comfortable to play, you can choose that method. But the most important thing here you have to remember is that once you do this, you have to save it. If you don't save it, next time you play this game, it will go back to the way it was before. So make sure once you are out of this, there is an option there to save the game remap file. So make sure you save it. So the next time, whenever you play this game, it will be saved. And if you don't do this, whenever you open this game again, it will go back to what it was originally. So make sure to save it, try it out, and if you find this video useful, please leave a like and subscribe to my channel, and stay tuned for more videos coming soon. Thank you so much.